Welcome to Bible Tract Echoes, a ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated. Our mission is to take the Word of God to all the world. Our Bible teacher today is the director of Bible Tracts Incorporated, Pastor Mark Smith. Since 1938, Bible Tracts Incorporated has been publishing clear gospel tracts and supplying them to churches and individuals all over the world, and all at no charge. Information on how you can receive a free sample packet of all of our tracts will be given at the end of this broadcast. And now for our Bible study, here's our teacher, Pastor Mark Smith.
Hello, my friend. Thank you so much for letting me be part of your day. If you're listening right now in your car, in your home, if you're listening at work, or you're listening on your iPod or whatever it is that you've downloaded our broadcast off of our website to, thank you for listening and allowing me to be part of your life. Right now, my Bible is sitting open to the Gospel of Mark and chapter 16. Mark 16, we will not complete our study in Mark this week. We will next week. And then we'll begin to deal with and answer some of the questions that have been asked us via our text messaging system. Now, if you're not a person that gets involved in text messaging but has some questions that you would like answered from the Bible, you can mail them to us or email them to us. When I get all done, my announcer is going to give our mailing address, an email address, a website, and so on. Any of those ways will work for you to ask us a question, and we'll be glad to include yours. Well, let me begin this way. Do you like mystery novels or detective stories? I like detective stories. Every now and again, there appears a story where the real criminal leaves false clues behind to try to throw the police off the track of the truth. Then, of course, in the story, there's that one detective who sees a flaw in these clues. Something does not fit together right, and this leads that detective to pursue a different angle on the crime, and of course, they discover the real criminal. Well, I say that because as we come to Mark 16, beginning at verse 9 today, we are left a lot of clues, or facts, if you would. Now, the good news is that our facts are true. They're not misleading facts. They're true things. They have not been left to us to get us off the track. They've been left to us to put us on the track. My question is, though, why did God leave us so many facts here in Mark chapter 16? I think there's a really good reason. Join me and let's discover the reason today. Now, I mentioned text messaging. At the end of the broadcast, I'm going to encourage you to text message me. And to do that, you text me the word gospel to the number I'm about ready to give. I'm going to give it now. I'll give it at the end of the broadcast as well. But if you'll text me the word gospel, then I'll begin to ask you some very simple, quick questions, and your response will help us. You'll be able to actually rate the broadcast, and that all of a sudden, this one-way communication becomes a two-way communication. But text me the word gospel. Here's the number. I'll give it twice, and again, I'll give it near the end of the broadcast. Text me the word gospel to area code 708-515-4086. That is 708-515-4086. Right now, I want to remind you that the Bible Tract Echoes is really the ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated, gospel tracts, gospel pamphlets that we can use to help share the gospel with people with whom we cannot often verbally go through the gospel. The one in my hand right now is entitled Ready to Die. Ready to Die. This is a testimonial tract about a young man named James Dunkley, who died on a second tour of duty in Iraq. This young man was a powerful servant of God in life and in death. And here's a great track for men, for young men, teenage boys, junior high age boys, even younger than that. This is a man's kind of a track. It'll encourage men to be men for Christ, and it also very clearly gives the gospel. Ready to Die. Would you let me send it to you, please? Remember, I said my announcer's going to be giving the means to communicate with us. If you pick out one of those and ask for the sample packet of our English gospel tracts, that track, Ready to Die, will be in there. Well, let me read today. Mark chapter 16, beginning at verse 9, here is what it says. Now when Jesus was risen early on the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had cast seven devils. And she went and told them that had been with him, as they mourned and wept. And they, when they heard that he was alive and had been seen of her, believed not. After that he appeared in another form unto the two of them, as they walked and went into the country. And they went and told it to the residue, neither believed they them. Afterward he, Jesus, appeared unto the 11 as they sat at meat. I'm going to stop right there. The fact about Jesus' resurrection begin to pile up here in Mark chapter 16. Now, we've already been told of the women at the tomb earlier in this chapter. Now we are told of people who met with Christ after his resurrection. Probably the most complete listing of the appearances of Jesus is to be found in 1 Corinthians chapter 15. But notice the appearance of Jesus here, the living Savior. Notice the appearances that are located here in our chapter. First of all, to Mary, verses 9 through 11. In these verses, two things seem to stick out to me. Number one is Mary's history, her being demonized. Now, why is that mentioned here? When Jesus saved this gal from her sin, he saved this person who was way, way, way down deep in sin. She had not just one demon possessing her body, she had seven. But by telling me that Mary's past here, I'm reminded why it was that Mary loved Jesus enough to be visiting the garden tomb at this day. She loved Christ so much because she had been saved from much. Second thing that sticks out to me here in his appearance to Mary is the disbelief of the disciples by Mary's resurrection knowledge. She goes and gives them the information, tells them the news that she had seen the risen Lord there in verse 11, but they don't believe her. Jesus' followers were not expecting his resurrection, and therefore they just imagine that Mary just saw something in her head. The disciples fought the idea and disbelieved the idea of Jesus' bodily resurrection from the dead. Did their tune ever change, boy, after they saw and met the risen Lord? Their lives were transformed. A second group here see Christ in verses 12 and 13. There, Jesus appears to two men on the road to Emmaus. Now, the fuller giving of that account is over in Luke chapter 24. These two men had heard Mary's report, but they doubted it. As they were walking, they were discussing the news of the supposed, to their minds, resurrection. After they met Jesus, though, they went back and they reported to the disciples themselves, "We have seen the risen Lord." But the disciples did not believe them. Thirdly, beginning in verse 14, Jesus appears to the 11 in the upper room. Note, all the 11 are present. Mark's record skips over the doubting Thomas story, but note again, these disciples were eating. They were not out looking for their risen Savior. They were not expecting Christ to arise from the dead. The point being made here in Mark 16 is that the disciples had to fight their human logic to come to openly believe in the resurrection of Jesus. They were not anticipating it. They were not planning for it. They even disbelieved some of the well-known trusted friends when they came and gave them the news that Jesus had risen from the dead. God knew that there would be skeptics and there would be doubters of the resurrection in every era of church history. So, what does God do? God, in his wisdom and caringness, puts skeptics, puts doubters right into the Bible passage so that you and I are provided assurance to everyone and all of us, and no matter what era that we live in, that Jesus is alive from the dead. Oh, there are people who have written books who just, they're not Bible believers. They want to be religious, but they don't want to be Bible believers. And they have written books about why Jesus just arose spiritually. He didn't arise from the dead bodily. Or they write and they say that the disciples longed for a Savior to rise from the dead so badly that they imagined it. Oh, friend, nothing could be farther from the truth. They were not expecting the risen Lord. So God has given to us the record of people who met Christ the very day of his resurrection. He confronts them with the reality of his bodily resurrection, and he then gives them the job to go report back to the disciples, and the disciples weren't ready for it. Oh, friend, are you ready for a resurrected Savior? Now, let me stop right here. I mentioned text messaging earlier in the broadcast. How does this broadcast and how does this news here about Jesus and all these appearances on the day of his resurrection, how does that impact you? What are you thinking right now? Why don't you text to me the word gospel? And here's the number. I'm going to give it to you twice. Are you ready? Text me the word gospel to area code 708-515-4086. 708, then the number is 515-4086. Now, dear friend, listen to me. You cannot be saved from your sin without believing in the resurrection of Jesus. Now, if you doubt that, you need to know that in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, the resurrection chapter, we are given the synopsis of what the gospel is. Paul says, I deliver unto you that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried and that he rose again according to the scriptures. The death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus is part of the good news of the gospel. You cannot have a Jesus dying for you and be saved by that. You need to believe in the resurrection of Jesus as well to be saved. Some people don't like that, but I can't change the gospel. I can't, don't have permission. I must preach and teach what the Bible says. Dear friend, do you believe in a resurrected Jesus in your head? Do you doubt, though, that really, I mean, you're saying to yourself, come on, Pastor Mark, a person rising from the dead? Yeah. You see, that's what makes Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ. That's one of the reasons we know he is the Son of God, God who came to earth in flesh and dwelt among us. He is now the mediator between God and men. It is appointed unto men once to die. But after that, the judgment. But who do you want to stand with that day when you stand before God? You want to stand there alone as a sinner, or do you want to stand there with in company with your lawyer? Because that's really what 1 John 2 describes Jesus as. He's our advocate. That's the word for lawyer. I'm going to stand someday before the Lord, and I'm going to have my lawyer next to me. And let me tell you about my lawyer. He has the perfect argument. The argument is his shed blood, his burial, and his resurrection. And my sins have been dealt with by him because of his grace and love for me. Have you received him? He died, was buried, and rose that you might be saved. Why not today make your day when you are resurrected from spiritual death to life, so that on the day of the bodily resurrection, you go to heaven instead of hell?
Thank you for joining us today for Bible Tract Echoes, a ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated. If you would like to receive a free sample packet of all of our tracts, you can contact us by calling 309-828-6888. That's 309-828-6888. Our mailing address is P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. A faster way to contact us is to go to our website at BibleTracksInc.org. That's BibleTracksInc.org. There you will find more information about our ministry and details on how you can support Bible Tracts Incorporated. Thanks for listening, and may the Lord richly bless you as you serve Him.